What?
Not what?
I have a really special announcement.
Are you guys ready? You're gonna like it. All right, Scruffy, tell them.
We are getting to sing in big church.
Can you say, woo? When, Scruffy?
On July 4th.
On July 4th, we're gonna get to sing for all your parents and grandparents and aunts and uncles and friends. Scruffy, do you remember what we're singing?
I think we're gonna do I'm in the Lord's Army, and I don't remember what else.
And I will pray for sure, and maybe a third song, we'll see. So, what do you think? Should we practice this morning?
Yeah,
can you guys help me sing it? Let's do I'm in the Lord's Army. Do you remember? We march, and we ride, and we shoot, and we fly, don't we? Or zoom is what the word is. All right, spread out just a little bit. So when you do your big airplane arms, that you don't whack your neighbor in the nose, all right? All right, Scruffy, let's do it, Miss Holly.
Okay.
Get your marching feet. Let's go. Let's start marching. We're ready.
thank you so much for this day. Thank you for all these boys and girls that came to learn about you today. Thank you that you brought Scruffy back to see us today and help us to listen to what you want to teach us. In your name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Good job. All right, stay seated. Okay, Scruffy, can you help the boys and girls out with something? Do you remember when you and I were talking this morning what I was building over here on the floor?
A jail?
A jail. And do you remember who was in the jail? Do you remember which disciple it was?
Was it Peter?
It was Peter. Good remembering. And do you and remember, boys and girls, last week we talked about 1 Peter, and we talked about how that some of the religious leaders weren't being very nice to the disciples, right? And they had their tents out, and some of them had to move from where they lived and to go to other places. And Peter wrote a letter, and he put it in the mail. Remember, it didn't look like this, but he put it in the mail, and he got letters out to churches spread all over the land. And he told them to keep believing what they had been learning from the Bible and from God's Word. I'm going to grab my Bible real quick, and we're going to talk about our Bible trivia, and then we're going to see what Peter wrote, but this time he wrote from jail. All right, Scruffy, what's our first question for our friends?
How many books are in the Bible?
How many?
Five.
No, how many? 60, 66, or 70?
70.
66, that's right. All right, my turn. How many big parts are in my Bible? Two or three?
Two.
All right, Scruffy, wait. Okay, Scruffy, your turn.
What are the two parts called?
The New Testament and the Old Testament.
Perfect. What's the part that comes at the back? Which testament?
The
New Testament. Good job. Scruffy?
What are the first four books of the New Testament?
All right, let's stomp them out. Sit down, but put your feet up. Ready? Let's stomp them. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. All right, perfect. All right. Is every word in my Bible true or just some of them?
Some of them.
What do you think? Some or all?
All.
What do you say, Strebby?
All.
All. Every single word in my Bible, in your Bible, in Miss Holly's Bible, in Strebby's Bible comes straight from God, and every single word is true. Okay, who came as a baby in the New Testament and made everything
Jesus.
New? Jesus. He sure did. And he grew up and he became a man and he did some things nobody else could do called miracles, exactly. All right. He loved us so much he went to the where to die?
A fox.
He died on the cross. Did he stay there?
Yes.
Yes, for a little bit, but where did he go after that?
To my mommy.
He went to the tomb and he stayed there for how many days? How many is in our song?
Three.
3 days, that's right. And then he came back. And he appeared to the disciples and other peoples. And where is Jesus now?
In heaven.
In heaven, that's right. The Bible tells us he sits at the right hand of God. So if I was God in heaven, he would stand right where Miss Holly is. I am so proud of you guys. You are so incredibly smart. You got all this right. All right, Trevi, can you stick around for a Bible story?
Sure.
All right. So we've been talking about the Old Testament, the New Testament, and our Bible study today is from the book of 2 Peter, and it is way back in my Bible. I'm going to show you how far back. Drop my paper clip, sorry. Okay, all the way back here. Look how few pages are left. We're almost at the end of our Bible, and then we're going to start over, and we're going to talk about the New Testament again. But today, we're going to talk about a letter. Poor Peter was in jail. You know why? He didn't do anything wrong. He was in jail because some people didn't like what he was saying. That he was telling others about God and about Jesus and about how much that he loves them. We know that Jesus went to the cross to forgive us of the things we did wrong, which we call sins, right? But they did not want Peter and the other disciples to keep telling about Jesus. So Peter sent another letter, and this is called 2 Peter in our Bible, and it was to give the people some more words of encouragement. And he said that you're going to have hard times, that everything's not always going to be like we want it to, but that Jesus gives us everything we need. He gives us the power inside of us to live the way he wants us to live. And he reminded the people in the church how they should try to live, that they should try to do good because that's what Jesus would do. That they would love others because that's what Jesus would do. That you should help other people if you can, not because it's how we get to heaven, but because it's the right thing to do, because that's what Jesus would do. And he says, if you have the ability to give someone a cup of water that's thirsty, or to give someone who needs clothes some clothes, then you should do so, because that's what Jesus would do. And Jesus is honored and he's happy when when we live like him. And Peter wanted the believers to remember that Jesus loved them so much that he went to the cross and he died for them. He died on the cross to take away their sins. And because of the cross, when Jesus invites us, God invites us to be part of his family. And when we believe in God and Jesus and read our Bibles, then we get baptized, right? We tell other people that how much we love him. And Peter wrote, he said, God has chosen you. He's chosen you and you and you and you and Scruffy and Miss Holly and Miss Brittany and I. He's chosen each one of us.
And what about me?
You too. Every single one of us, Freddie. He's chosen every single one of us to be a part of his family. And because he's chosen us to be a part of his family, he gives us the Holy Spirit inside of us to help us live like Jesus. And he wants us to remember that the disciples and the Bible, they don't give us make-believe stories. Always, always remember, every single word in this Bible is true. And it's about how much God loves you and what he's done for you and how he wants you to live your life. Okay? All right. So, let's stand up, and we've got time for at least one more song. What do you think, Scruffy? We'll let you vote this morning. Do you think we should do The Superhero Strong or Be Brave and Be Strong?
Let's do the superhero one.
The super one? All right. Miss Holly reminded us of that one, and we've had a lot of fun with the superhero song. We might have time for Be Brave and Be Strong or something else, too. Remember how to fly? You got an S on your chest, and you've got Batman, and Spider-Man, and so we're better at the top.
I'm gonna shout, praise the Lord. I'm gonna clap, clap, clap. I'm gonna snap, snap, snap. Murphy's been sleeping in while he was on vacation. You have a what on your neck?
A bug bite.
A bug bite. It happens. All right, everybody tell Scrubby bye.
Bye.
Bye. We love you. All right, y'all are free till next week. Have a great week. Thank you for singing with us.